We previously learned about supernovas, and we saw that they're individual stars, really massive stars, that at the end of their life sort of collapse down and violently explode, and they get so bright that they can outshine an entire galaxy. I want to show you a couple examples of that. What we didn't say before, and what's really important, is that these supernovas are a form of standard candles that allow us to measure the distance to galaxies. So here's an example of a galaxy where you can see before the supernova, you don't see anything really of note right where the arrow's pointing. You can't see any individual star there. It's just sort of a diffuse glow. And then when the supernova is happening, which can last several weeks, you see this super bright star. And that's a single star, which has just gotten incredibly bright, right? And so astronomers then, when they see that supernova, they could measure its brightness. And we'll see how that can tell us about the distance. Now, here's another example of an even more distant galaxy. Right? So it's so far away we can't take a very good picture of it. Above you see there is no supernova, and then you see there is a supernova and it's really bright. Now, what good can supernovas do for us? How do they work like standard candles? Well, here's a nice simulation which shows it. When a supernova explodes, it has a very characteristic shape to its light curve, we call it. That is how much light it gives off. Right? And what happens is the star will get really, really bright over the course of like a week. And then it will reach this peak brightness, and then it will gradually get way fainter right away, and then slowly fade away. Now, what's important about that is that supernovas all reach the same peak luminosity, which is to say, when they're at their brightest point, right, they all are at that same luminosity. They're giving off a total amount of light, which is sort of universal. So anywhere in the universe, in any galaxy, when a star goes supernova, it reaches the same peak luminosity or actual brightness, that is, right? Now, why does that matter? Well, when we look at a star in our sky, right, if it's a certain brightness in our sky, and we know the actual brightness of that star out in another galaxy, we can figure out how far away it is, right? It's the same idea that if you have a light bulb really close to you, it looks bright. If you bring that light bulb really far away, it looks a lot fainter, but that light bulb has the same luminosity, right? So that's really simple physics that allows astronomers to calculate how far away the star is based on how faint it appears in our sky. So what the simulation shows is on the left-hand side is like the luminosity, the actual brightness that's given off. The right-hand side is sort of how bright it appears in our sky, and I can adjust that. Now, by adjusting that, effectively what I'm doing is kind of figuring out how far away it is. I'm like moving the object closer or further to sort of say what's its actual distance. So what's cool about the simulation is that it has real data from real supernovas. So check this out. I'm gonna kind of scan it around. All right, and I can actually move it left and right too. So this is a real supernova that happened in 1994, and these were the brightness measurements that astronomers took. So I can kind of slide around and say, where does it match up with our model? So right about there, I'd say. Right? So we didn't catch its absolute peak, but I can kind of get an estimate then of how far away this object must be. And I can plug in some numbers from the simulation and figure that out. Let me use another example, 1987. Well, this one was extremely well studied. And you see it has sort of a different shape. So astronomers are still trying to figure that out. Why do some supernovas have slightly different shapes? But we can still kind of put it on the same curve and get an estimate of the actual distance. All right, here's another one. All right. Now here's the real trick is what astronomers really want to do is catch it right when it's at the peak of that supernova. And that's really hard to do because it comes up so quickly that to identify a supernova within a week and then keep observing it can be kind of tricky. All right, so a supernova, oh, that's a really good one. All right. So when we find a supernova in a distant galaxy, we can actually get a very accurate measurement of the distance to that galaxy. So that's one example of a standard candle. Another kind of standard candle uses variable stars, in particular a certain type of variable star. So this is a big field of study in its own right, and I just want to mention it, but stars sometimes can vary in their brightness, and different stars sort of vary in different kinds of ways. So you can see some of these, this is showing the brightness of a star over time, like over maybe a few weeks or a few days or even a few hours, and they all have different shapes to their variations. Well, there's one kind of variation, which is down here at the bottom, which is a very specific shape that we see both in our galaxy and we can see in some stars in other galaxies. We call that a Cepheid variable. And this is another standard candle. Stars that pulsate this way and have this very specific shape to their variation, they tend to all have the same luminosity or be the same sort of intrinsic brightness. So the really crazy thing about these is that the period of their variation, which is to say the time from one bright spot to the next one, actually corresponds to how luminous the variable star actually is. So if astronomers measure the amount of time it takes to go from bright to faint to bright again, they can actually get a really good estimate of the luminosity of this star and then use it as a standard candle. So here's a really nice graphic which shows for a particular Cepheid variable star in one of our nearest galaxies, it shows how they've measured its brightness over the course of a year and very accurately measured its period. That allows them to figure out the actual luminosity of that star and then look at its brightness in our sky and ultimately calculate, just like with supernovas, calculate the distance to that galaxy. So this becomes a nice comparison. It's totally independent of the supernova method. So astronomers can use multiple different approaches to measure the distance to the same galaxy and try to get a sense of how accurate those measurements really are.